Hello friends, welcome to Freshers Live. Today is 15th April. Here I will discuss all the important questions that may be asked from today's current affairs and important facts related with each question. So watch the video very carefully and try to answer the question asked at the end of the video. You can download the PDF of the video from the link provided in the description. You can also download the PDF from our website as well as Telegram groups. Also, you can find the link for the Hindi version of this video in the below given description box. The link for the Hindi current affairs is given there. Before moving forward, let's check the answer for the question asked in the last video. The Battle of Kohima was fought in the year - The correct answer is option C, 1944. Now let's begin our session for today. Here comes our question number 1. Which bank ranked number 1 in the Forbes list Best Indian Banks 2019? The correct answer is option D, HDFC Bank. The private lender HDFC Bank was ranked at the top of the Forbes Best Indian Banks 2019 list. HDFC Bank claims to provide the best of its technological features to its 43 million customers. Another private lender, ICICI Bank, took the second spot, while DBS was at the third rank in Forbes list of Indian banks. Kotak Mahindra Bank and IDFC Bank had managed to gain the fourth and fifth spot respectively. Syndicate Bank, PNB, Allahabad Bank, Vijaya Bank and Axis Bank were ranked from 6th to 10th respectively. Forbes has compiled a first ever list of the world's best bank 2019 in terms of customer service and technological advancements. Forbes had partnered with Statista, a market research company, to measure the best banks in 23 countries. The survey compiled data from around 40,000 customers around the world for their opinions on their banking relationship. The banks were rated on the basis of 5 key attributes: trust, digital services, financial advices, and fees. Now, let me share few more information about HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank is India's largest private sector lender by assets. The CEO is Aditya Puri. The headquarter is Mumbai. The founder is August 1994, India. It has a presence in Bahrain, Hong Kong and Dubai. Heading to our question number 2. Who is appointed as Secretary of Defense Finance? The correct answer is option A, Gargi Kaul. The central government appointed Gargi Kaul as Secretary, Defence Finance. She is a 1984 batch officer of the Indian Audit and Account Service. She was earlier Financial Advisor, Defence Services in the Defence Ministry. Now let me share few more information about the Ministry of Defence. It was formed in the year 1776 as Military Department. And in August 1994, it has been into a Ministry of Defense. It is headquartered at New Delhi. The minister responsible is Nirmala Sitharaman. The deputy minister is Dr. Subhash Ramrao Bhamre. It is responsible for coordinating and supervising all agencies and functions of the government relating directly to national security and the Indian Armed Forces. Heading to our question number 3. Who was sworn in as the new Prime Minister of Palestine? The correct answer is option B, Mohammed Ishtai. Palestine's new Prime Minister, Mohammed Ishtai, a veteran peace negotiator and harsh critic of Gaza's Hamas rulers, and his 22-member cabinet took the oath of office a second time on April 14, 2019, after botched oath. The ministers neglected to indulge a clause pledging faithfulness to the people and its national heritage during ceremony on April 13. The new cabinet replaces a technocratic government formed by Rami Hamdala in 2014. Now let me share few more informations about Palestine. The capitals are Ramallah, East Jerusalem. The president is Mohammed Abbas. The currencies are Israel shekel, Jordanian dinar and Egyptian pound. Heading toward question number 4. Who has been selected for the prestigious Saraswati Samman 2018? The correct answer is option A, Shiva Reddy. Telugu poet K. Shiva Reddy selected for the prestigious Saraswati Samman 2018 for his collection of poetry titled Pakkaki Ottigilit. Award carries a cash prize of 15 lakh rupees, a citation and a plaque. The award, instituted by the K.K. Birla Foundation in 1991, is given annually for an outstanding literary work written in any Indian language and published during the last 10 years. Now let me share few more informations about the Saraswati Samman 2018 awards. The Saraswati Samman is an annual award for outstanding prose or poetry literary works in any 22 Indian language listed in Schedule 8 of the Constitution of India. It is named after an Indian goddess of learning and is considered to be among the highest literary award in India. Currently held by Sitanshu Yashas Chandran. Heading toward question number 5. Who won the UNESCO Guillermo Canopus Freedom Prize 2019 for their reports on human rights violation in Myanmar's state of Rakhine? The correct answer is option B, Reuters reporters Wah Loan and Kyaw So Oo. The UNESCO Guillermo Canopus Freedom 2019 has been awarded to Reuters reporters Wah Loan and Kyaw So Oo. The prize carries a reward of $25,000. The award recognized their exceptional courage in reporting on alleged human rights violation in the Myanmar's state of Rakhine. Both Wah Loan and Kyaw So Oo's documentary on the taboo topic regarding crimes committed against Rohingyas landed them behind the bars. The award paid a tribute to their courage, resistance and commitment to freedom of expression. Now let me share few more informations about the UNESCO Guillermo Canopus Freedom Prize. The award is established in the year 1997. The prize is named after the Guillermo Cano Zasa, the Colombia's journalist who was assassinated in front of the offices of his newspaper El Espectador in Bogota, Colombia on 17th December 1986. It is an initiative of UNESCO's executive board. It honors a person, organization that has made an outstanding contribution to the defense and or promotion of press freedom anywhere in the world in the face of danger. Heading to our question number 6. Who were recently inducted as MCC Honorary Life Members? The correct answer is option A, Inzamam ul Haq, Mark Boucher. Pakistan's Inzamam ul Haq and South African Mark Boucher were inducted as the honorary life members of the Melbourne Cricket Club in recognition to their outstanding achievement in the game of cricket. Now, let me share few more informations about Inzamam ul Haq. Former Pakistan skipper and batsman, Inzamam played 120 tests, 378 one-day internationals and one 2020 international. In test, he scored 8,830 runs at an average of 49.60 with 25 centuries and 46 half centuries. In ODIs, he tallies 11,339 runs at an average of 39.52. He made his international debut in 1991, featuring in Pakistan's successful 1992 World Cup champion. World Cup campaign. He captained Pakistan from 2001 to 2007. After his retirement in 2007, Inzamam had a brief stint with the Afghanistan national team as head coach. In 2016, he became Pakistan's chief selector. Inzamam is now the fifth honorary life member of the MCC from Pakistan after Imran Khan, Wasim Akram and Waqar Younis and Shahid Afridi. Now let me share few more information about Mark Boucher. He was the first wicketkeeper to climb 500 catches in Test. He made his international debut in 1997 and retired in 2012. He holds the record of the most wicket-keeping dismissals across formats, 998 in total. Boucher is also the fifth honorary life member of the MCC from South Africa after Alan Donald, Jonty Rhodes, Shaun Pollock and Darryl Cullinan. Moving to our question number 7. Who was honored with Lifetime Achievement Award 2019 during 4th APJ Abdul Kalam Innovation Conclave? The correct answer is Option A, Dr. A.K. Singh. Dr. A.K. Singh, Director at Life Science DRDO, has been honored with Lifetime Achievement Award 2019 during 4th APJ Abdul Kalam Innovation Conclave at Chandigarh University, Mohali. He has made notable contributions in internal decorporation of fission, produced radionuclides and infection imaging. He also discovered a diagnobact kit in detect the infectious lesion. He also introduced pharmacocinigraphy, that is application of nuclear medicine imaging in drug research. Now let me share few more information about 4th Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Innovation Conclave. For Best Innovation Project Award 2019, 965 innovation projects competed against each other. Pankaj Sharma bagged the first position and Best Innovation of the Year Award 2019 for Smart Trolley Bag Project. Pratul and Abhishek shared second place. Pratul acquired award for Automatic Toilet Cleaner Project. Abhishek won for the Prototype Model for Accident Management System respectively. Third prize was jointly won by Vaibhav and Daniel for treatment of textile effluent and plastic with biomass to help the controlling water and air pollution. Now, let me share few more information about DRDO. It was formed in the year 1958. It is headquartered at New Delhi. The chairman is Dr. G. Satish Reddy. The minister responsible is Nirmala Sitharaman. The parent is Ministry of Defense. It is charged with the military's research and development. Heading to our question number 8. Which of the following Israeli lunar mission crashed on the moon? The correct answer is Option B, Beersheet. Israel's lunar mission Beersheet crashed on the moon. It crashed during a landing attempt. It is said that the spacecraft had problem with its main engine during its descent that left it unable to slow down in time before it smashed into the lunar surface. Now, let me share the information about the mission. Beersheet was an Israeli mission launched by a partnership between non-profit SpaceL and government-owned aerospace company Israel Aerospace Industries. It is the world's first privately funded lunar mission. Beersheet lander can carry a science instrument provided by NASA, a retroreflector instrument scientists would have used to make precise measurements of the distance between Earth and the Moon. Beersheet mission's design include risk. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and SpaceL have announced that the team will now start working on Beersheet 2.0. Now, let me share few more information about Israel. The president is Reuven Rivlin. The Prime Minister is Benjamin Netanyahu. The official language is Hebrew. The capital is Jerusalem. The currency is new shekel. Heading to our question number 9. Who won gold in 54 kg category at the Boxing World Cup at Kolling in Germany? The correct answer is option A, Meena Kumari Maisnam. Meena Kumari from Manipur climbed the gold medal in the 54 kg category at the Boxing World Cup at Kolling in Germany. She defeated Thailand's Bai Chai Bunyanat in the final. Meena was the 2014 Asian Championship bronze medalist. India bagged a gold, 2 silver and 2 bronze medals at the Boxing World Cup. Sakshi won silver in 57 kg category and Pillau Basmatari in 64 kg category. Pinky Rani won bronze in 51 kg and Parvin won bronze in 60 kg category. Now, let me share few more informations about the Kolling Boxing World Cup. It is earlier known as Chemistry Cup. It witnessed participation from more than 20 nations and 160 boxers in 7 women and 10 men weight classes. It is one of the strongest international events in Europe with nearly 50 years of tradition. The first edition was held in 1970. Now, let me share few more informations about Germany. The president is Frank-Walter Steinmeier. The capital is Berlin. The official language is German. The currency is Euro. Now, heading to our last question, question number 10. Which of the following initiation of Rotary Club of Madras North provides sanitary napkins to the students? The correct answer is option B, Project Kannamma. Project Kannamma is the initiative of the Rotary Club of Madras North, Tamil Nadu. It aims to provide sanitary napkins to the students. Now, let me share few more information about Project Kannamma. It was started in August 2018 by providing free biodegradable sanitary napkins to 82 students at the government high school in Uthandi of Tamil Nadu. Under the Project Kannamma, sanitary napkins are provided to over 300 students from across government schools in and around Chennai today. These sanitary napkins are provided in the Irula Tribal Women's Welfare Society. The project is also supporting the livelihood of Irula tribal women. If the group sells 15,000 pads per month, it can sustain the families of 12 tribal women. To conclude this session, here comes the question of the day. Who is the Deputy Minister of Ministry of Defence? Try to answer the question and drop your answer in the comment box. Okay friends, that's for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you find the information provided in our video useful, please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Follow us regularly to stay updated on current affairs. Dear friends, are you looking for a job? End your search now. Visit freshersliv.com, the next generation of placement network. Register yourself today and get placed in top companies. Until then, this is Freshers Live signing out from Current Affairs video. Take care.